SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways across Australia.
You're listening to Australia Explained, an SBS audio podcast helping you navigate life in Australia.
Australian Boxing Day is a unique blend of cultural and commercial significance. While it doesn't have a solid religious connotation here, it's a day where Australians extend their Christmas festivities. It's often a time for family barbecues, cricket matches, and watching the iconic Sydney to Hobart yacht race.
At the heart of Boxing Day, for many Australians, it's considered a day that is where people can relax after the momentum that builds and the rush that happens in the lead up to Christmas.
On the other hand, many Australians look forward to this day to sweep the stores for the best bargains.
Boxing Day sales traditionally have been the premier retail shopping event on the calendar.
I'm your host, Maram Smail. And today we have a special episode about all that you need to know about Boxing Day in Australia. Boxing Day, celebrated on the 26th of December, is a public holiday in Australia, following the Christmas celebrations for Western Christians. This day has its roots in British history, where it was traditionally a day to give Christmas boxes to service workers. Professor Constant Muse from the Centre for Religious Studies at Monash University says the tradition of giving a Christmas box goes back to the 16th century.
Was a gift of generosity, often to servants and tradespeople. That's how it sort of originated in the 16th and 17th centuries. And it wasn't just to members of your own family, but to those who had helped you and who might be working absolutely every day of the week, except perhaps a little day off on Sundays. So it was really a way of cutting across the social divisions. That's how it started, but it obviously transforms.
It transformed into a day of relaxation, sports, and famous Boxing Day sales in Australia in the last 19th and early 20th century, according to Professor Muse. Buying gifts for others or yourself means shopping. It is an activity that millions of people around Australia get involved in. Boxing Day sales are an excellent opportunity for shoppers to grab deals on everything from electronics to clothing. Brian Walker, CEO and founder of Retail Doctors Group, says these sales are a big deal in Australia, with significant discounts across countless stores.
Boxing Day sales traditionally have been the premier retail shopping event on the calendar. From December the 26th, for about 7 days, approximately $23 to $25 billion in sales is done from that period nationally in Australia. And the Boxing Day itself, the 26th, is the largest single day with about $3 to $4 billion.
Mr. Walker adds that Boxing Day has been with us since the 80s and the 90s and is dominated by the growth of big department stores.
Well, the Australian and global retail scene has changed quite a lot since those days. And now there are considerably many more competitors than there were in those days, considerably more demand and considerably more stock. So it's a more competitive environment for retailers at one level. It's a more competitive environment for shoppers who are well researched to do well in.
Boxing Day is a pleasurable activity for some, especially the hunt for bargains that retailers offer. Australian Style Institute founder Lauren Di Bartello says Boxing Day is an important sale time for Australians. But it's not the only sale time. In the lead up to Boxing Day, we have Click Frenzy in October and November, Black Friday and Cyber Monday in late November.
From a fashion and lifestyle perspective, Boxing Day is very much about going and purchasing the pieces that you may have had on your wish list for a little while. And it's the opportunity to actually buy them knowing that they'll be reduced significantly. Retailers tend to purchase quite a lot of stock in the lead up to Christmas and that time of year. So Boxing Day is really where they then go to clean out all of the additional stock that they've purchased.
While sales can be exciting, it's essential to create a budget, allocate a specific amount for shopping, and stick to it. Professor of Finance Nadia Masoud from the Melbourne Business School explains.
First, you need to list the sources of income or revenue, and then list the itemized expenses. And there is some expenses that are stable and have no control over them. This is what we call fixed expenses. And there are variable ones. We consider them as discretionary. And this is where you have full control, where you can make choices.
She advises consumers to think of the Boxing Day sales as an opportunity to decrease the amount of fixed expenses overall.
If you have children and they're growing in age and you must buy some shoes, clothes for them, then you plan ahead of time and buy those important items during the Boxing Day sales. The discretionary ones, this is where actually you have to be careful not to overspend and make sure that you are buying stuff that you need. It is a budget. In other words, the expenses should not exceed the revenue.
The big sale season starts between the mid-November window through the end of Jan every year, with expected spending of approximately $70 billion, according to Mr. Walker. You can find sales and deals online and in-store on Boxing Day. It's really about your preference. But with the rise of online shopping, Mr. Walker says it's crucial to shop safely.
Know the retailer. Ensure that their actual online process is secure. Check the banking details. Check that all the security apps are in place. But I think more than anything, know the retailer. Know that the site is secure. And all reputable retailers have secure transaction pathways and secure sites.
If you decide to hit the road and shop in person, research and planning in advance can help you navigate the Boxing Day with the most desired results. Ms. Di Bartello again.
Research is good, particularly if you're watching a budget this year, because certainly it's so easy to overspend. And that's really what a lot of the wording and marketing that surround these deals help to do. You know, they incentivize us spending money.
If you prefer to avoid researching and shopping in store or at a shopping center, Ms. Di Bartello advises keeping your budget and needs in mind while making purchases.
There's a part of the brain called the reticular activating system. This is sort of part of the psychology of style. What it does is it has us looking for more of the same thing that is already familiar to us. So what that can mean is often we will go looking for things that we already have in the wardrobe. So I think the best research you can do is to look within your own wardrobe and your own home at what you do have, and don't go and buy more of the same thing if you don't need it.
As consumers in Australia, it's essential to know that your consumer rights are well protected. Knowing these can save you a lot of trouble. Under Australian consumer law, you are entitled to a refund, repair, or replacement for faulty, unsafe products that don't match their description. Keep your receipts and don't hesitate to raise issues with the retailer. New South Wales Fair Trading Commissioner Natasha Mann explains.
Most products that you buy in Australia come with a consumer guarantee that the product will work and it will do what you asked for. Products need to be of an acceptable quality. And so what that means is three things. They need to be safe and lasting with no faults. They need to look acceptable, so no scratches or dents or anything like that.
Ms. Mann adds that it doesn't matter whether you've purchased online or in store. Your rights are the same, but it can be more complex when you have purchased from an overseas seller.
During the Boxing Day sales, just make sure that you're purchasing what you want to purchase, because if you change your mind, you're not automatically entitled to a refund.
Shopping is a big part of Boxing Day in Australia, but it still has the warm social aspect. Ms. Di Bartello says it's about bringing people together, relaxing, and eating Christmas leftovers.
Boxing Day doesn't need to be a day that's about spending and shopping. At the heart of Boxing Day, for many Australians, it's considered a day that is where people can relax after the momentum that builds and the rush that happens in the lead up to Christmas. in particular. And it's where people can actually come together and take a breath. Yeah, relax. Usually eating leftovers if they have celebrated Christmas the day before.
Thank you for listening to this episode of Australia Explained. Written, produced and hosted by me, Maram Smail. Australia Explained Managing Editor is Rosa Germian.
This was an SBS audio podcast. For more Australia Explained stories, visit sbs.com.au/Australia Explained.